So far, we have seen two ways to use trigonometric substitution. There is a third way, and that's when we have something of the form x squared minus 1. So with this form, we use the trig identity. We're going to use the same trig identity that 1 plus tangent squared of theta equals secant squared of theta, but we're going to move the 1 over to the left-hand side, so that we have tangent squared of theta equals secant squared of theta minus 1. So now we're going to let x be secant of theta, and that will be our substitution. Now we can also generalize these substitutions we've been making. So far we've had 1 minus x squared, we've had 1 plus x squared, and we just saw x squared minus 1. So we can generalize these by if we have another number here instead of 1, or if we have a number here in front of the x. So let's say that we had 36 minus x squared. All right. So, in this case, we have been wanting to get something that looks like 1 minus x squared. And we can do this by pulling out a 36. So we get 36 times a quantity, 1 minus x squared over 36. Now, we have the 1 that we want, but instead of x squared, we have x squared divided by 36. So if we pull out the squared term, we get 36 times the quantity 1 minus x over 6 quantity squared. And now we can use the substitution that u equals x divided by 6. And that will give us 36 times 1 minus u squared, which looks like the substitution, which looks like the form for the substitution we want to make. And we were using the trig identity that 1 minus sine squared of theta equals cosine squared of theta. So if u is x over 6, then we want to let u be sine of theta as well. And so we can use this long substitution process where we go from x's to u's to thetas. But we can make this simpler. If we know that u is x divided by 6 and u is sine of theta, then x over 6 equals sine of theta, which means that x equals 6 sine of theta. So if we go up to our original expression that we had, 36 minus x squared, we know that x equals 6 sine of theta. So that says we have 36 minus, and x is squared, so we have to square this whole quantity. 36 minus the quantity 6 sine of theta quantity squared. So that gives us 36 minus 36 sine squared theta. Now before in the past, we had gone ahead and when we had 1 minus sine squared theta, we substituted in for cosine squared of theta. But we have this 36 now. So, if we want to use this identity, we can multiply through by 36. Get 36 minus 36 sine squared theta equals 36 cosine squared theta. So that tells me that 36 minus 36 sine squared theta equals 36 cosine squared theta. So to sum this up, when we have something that looks like a squared minus x squared, our substitution is going to be x equals a times sine of theta, and we use the identity that a squared minus a squared sine squared theta equals a squared cosine squared theta. And the same generalizing process can be used when we have something of the form a squared plus x squared or x squared minus a squared. So to sum this up, if we have the expression a squared minus u squared, we use a substitution u equals a sine of theta, where theta runs from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2, and the simplification a squared minus u squared equals a squared cosine squared theta. If we have a squared plus u squared, then we use the substitution u equals a times tangent of theta, where theta is between negative pi over 2 to pi over 2, and those endpoints are not included. Our simplification is that a squared plus u squared equals a squared secant squared of theta. And finally, for the expression u squared minus a squared, we use the substitution u equals a secant of theta, where theta runs from 0 to pi, but theta cannot be pi over 2, with the simplification that u squared minus a squared equals a squared times tangent squared of theta. So this may still seem a little confusing. I recommend that you look through all the examples we've provided in this video and try as many as you can until you get comfortable with the process.